All right, we're checking in with Ryan Villopoto this week. RV, so you're out at Glen Helen, and you're just smashing motos in preparation for the rain-delayed two-stroke national.
I'm lucky there was a rain delay, actually. I think I had been on the bike, I don't know, not a lot, once or twice. So because of the rain delay, now I'm like, I need to go out and row, because I rode the 250, and I'm like, my arms aren't ready for these hills, so I'm out here now.
You're out here. So you had said, when we got news of the delay, you said, oh, now I got time to maybe run around the block a couple times. Have you put on the running shoes yet?
No running shoes. Running's not my thing, so neither is the training part. But because of the delay, we pushed it back about a month or so. Yeah. So I think it's April 19, 2021 or so.
It's on 420.
Yeah, right? So I figured it was time to start kind of riding a little bit. So that's what I'm doing. I'm trying to put in a couple, you know, some laps and just get a little more, more comfortable, you know?
Yeah. Okay. So the bike that the guys built you looks like a fire breather. Pretty good. How does it compare to, straight rhythm bike that you had?
Yeah. It's the same head, same cylinder, basically the same package Mitch did. So that's what I'll be racing at. That was at Straight Rhythm. Same bike Kenny rode, that cylinder head, that whole package, is the same package that we'll be racing out here. So no, it's good for a YZ250 or a two stroke in general.
Yeah,
it's fun. It's got good power.
All right, so the four stroke revolution happened, you know, right as you were turning pro or a little bit before.
Yeah,
so you never professionally raced a full size two stroke.
No, I didn't. I never raced a two-stroke in anything AMA professional.
Yeah.
But I did spend a lot of time on the KX250, mm-hmm. Because the Cowie 450 didn't come out till a few years later.
Yeah, yeah.
So as an amateur, I had the 250F platform, steel frame platform, and then we raced the steel or the KX250 for the 250 class.
Okay. Is it at your level? Like, is it hard to go from two to four stroke, or is it pretty easy?
I mean, I would say it's way harder now that I don't ride a lot or enough, I should say. But no, I can jump on it and pretty much ride it. You know, like I spent, you know, a fair amount of time, like especially on a 250 two stroke platform. So no, it's pretty, it's easy. I mean, it's not hard.
Nice. So, the guys at Backyard, their website, they have this configurator, right, where you could design your own. And Philip from Backyard was over one time. We were talking. He was giving me crap because I always just send them a list of logos I want.
Yep.
And they do it. And so then I was like, wait, really? Am I the only guy that does that? And they're all, just you and RV. So
yeah, I don't design any of my stuff.
Yeah, you ought to try it. It's pretty fun.
I'm not a designer. Like that's why they are the designers.
But it's kind of like playing a video game. You get to change this, change that. But it does take
I don't have
time.
Much of a creative mind in that sense of like coming up what looks good, what doesn't look good. So I'll leave that up to the experts.
Yeah.
Just tell them what logos I need and then have them
so
design.
When they send you this design proof for this bike, do you just go, yeah, it looks good? Or do you
I'll make little little changes here or there. But most of the time I just run it. You know, it's easier to do it that way. Just send them to me and we'll put them on.
I see the little texture design in the white behind you.
Oh yeah, my Michael Jordan look here.
Yeah. Is that what that's is?
I don't know. I think that's what it is. I don't know. They showed up like this. Like I said, I saw the proofs. I'm like, yeah, it looks good.
Looks good.
So, they do a good job. Their stuff's nice.
So, what else is new in the RV2 world? I know you got a new badass trailer, and you're building a garage.
Yeah, just trying to finish up my house construction. Feels like I've been living in construction for almost 2 years now.
Yeah.
So I'm over that by far. So finishing up my garage. I want to try to start riding a little bit more. Mm-hmm. You know, now that the kids are you know, 8:30 to 3 in school and I have some downtime during the day, so try to start riding more, you know. We'll see. I don't know if once it gets really hot that might deter me a little bit, but
it becomes less appealing.
Yeah, it's not very appealing. The pool sounds better than Glen Helen at 98 degrees on a Thursday.
What are the kids into now? Are you
so right now? Down? Yeah, right now we're pretty heavy into baseball right now, and they both want to ride. One, Gage, really wants to kind of start riding and racing. I feel like I can make them or get them to be good on a motorcycle, even if we start at, say, 10, 11. Yes, it's later than these Loretta's kids. But my point in saying that is if I don't give them the opportunity to play baseball, if that's what they want to do, there's no way I can catch them up in baseball. I can catch them up in here, obviously. I know the whole industry. Obviously, I know how to make a guy fast. Especially your own kid. So I'm kind of just in this limbo, you know, kind of waiting.
Did you play ball as a kid?
No, I never. I mean, I played soccer for a little bit.
Yeah.
Up until about 10, 11. So I'm kind of just, like I said, I'm kind of in limbo, just kind of waiting for them to really say, hey, this is what I want to do.
Yeah, a choice.
Which he's kind of already said that, but he still says he wants to play baseball. So that, you know, we can't do both. I mean, there's already two or three practices a week, and then you have your swing coach and you have your pitching coach and all of that, right? It's just like moto. It's just like moto. So give them the best opportunity in that arena if they want to do that. But like I said, they have I feel like they have a little bit of time to, you know, if they want to go down this road, that I can speed that up, you know, once we start.
Yeah.
So that's kind of where we're at. Just kind of, like I said, kind of in that limbo, just kind of waiting for them to kind of choose.
Was there a learning curve for you with baseball, being a baseball dad? When my kids were in soccer, I think we were like 5 or 6 years in before one day I was like, well, how come sometimes it's a corner kick? Sometimes it's a free throw. Like,
yeah, I mean, I don't know all the rules. We're playing kid pitch right now, so it's just as serious as doing the moto stuff full on. So it's cool. Like, you know, we're on a good team. Our coaches are good. Like, they want to play at a high level, meaning the coaches, the team, the way they coach. So that's good. You know, it's giving them the best shot. But like I said, I'm just kind of waiting. Whatever road they want to go, like I told them, I said, if you want to play baseball, you can do that. I mean, we're going to be height challenged regardless. So they're going to have to be really good, right? So, but right now it's just for fun, you know, like they just got to, if they want to do that, they got to keep doing it. And Moto will just have to kind of wait.
Mm-hmm. What if Brax came to you and said, Dad, I want to play the flute?
I might just go and get him an electric guitar instead. I don't know. I mean, as a, you know, you don't want to hold them back from anything they want to do, but
you're hoping it's something athletic.
But also, you can kind of push directions. Yeah. You know,
how about golf? You get him clubs yet?
We have clubs. Oh yeah, John, we have it all. I mean, we have clubs. We have the Stasics. We have the, you know, the motorcycles, the baseballs, they like flag football too. Like, they were bummed they couldn't play flag because baseball takes place of that now. You know, at the level they're playing at now, you got to pick one or the other. So
seasons conflict.
Yeah, they kind of conflict. And if they do want to ride a little bit, I'm like, you can't do flag, baseball, and ride. You know, it's kind of one or the other. It's baseball full-time and ride a little bit, or moto full-time. And really not baseball, because you can't miss the games. You know, you leave your team out. It's team sport stuff, you know?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. What else? So 02 bikes?
Yeah,
you're still part of that?
Yeah, we got the 02 stuff going on right now. We're on, we just got that all loaded up on Amazon too.
Mm-hmm. Oh shit, that's when it really gets.
Well, we'll see. You know, Amazon's tricky to kind of get on that platform, number one. A lot of paperwork kind of involved and certifications and things like that. But yeah, we just got on there a few weeks ago. It's growing nice and slowly. Yeah. Obviously, the economy right now in general isn't that stellar.
Yeah.
But we're still selling. Things are good there. It's not growing, obviously, as fast as we would like. Mm-hmm. It's kind of in this transition point. We either need to get kind of like big box, or just kind of keep going, grinding away and trying to build it.
Title 2-4, how's the podcast life?
The pod's good. Yeah, no, the pod's a lot of fun, actually. That is a lot of fun with myself, Ricky. Aaron's our producer. JH is like co-producer on that. So we get to, you know, obviously dissect every Saturday night or every Saturday night's race on Monday and get it out up on Tuesday. I mean, this season's been obviously filled with content and filled with you know, action and just a lot of things going on, just like we saw last Saturday night with positions docked and red cross flags and obviously the Jet and Barcia deal and so it's been action packed, that's for sure. It's a lot of fun.
Isn't it crazy how different outside influences affect things within the sport, like namely social media, like from when you were racing, say?
Oh yeah, it's way different, honestly. You know, like we always had Vital MX or, you know, a place where you could go and you know, get on your rant and be able to talk smack, you know, on the riders or on situations that have happened. But now it's everybody has a cell phone. Mm-hmm. Everybody can comment. It's a little over the top, you know, like especially when you have some of these guys out there that maybe ride recreationally or, you know, just enjoy the sport but don't really ride that much, to have so much influence or to have so much you know, so many things to say.
Yeah.
It's a bit gnarly. You know, even like guys like myself, you know, I know Ricky gets beat up all the time, like the last Hayden Deegan thing that happened when he cut across the start, you know, like I got ratballed, you know, pretty hard on social with that. You know, and it's like, guys, you don't even, if you're starting on the outside like that, like he did, like if I'm any one of those guys on the inside of that gate, I'm being like, hey, there's a YZ250F out, it's Star's bike, it's fast, he's starting on the outside. If that dude gets any sort of jump, he's gonna saw everybody off. Like I would be the first, that'd be the first thing I think about if I'm up on the inside and he's on the outside, you know? Yeah. So, and it's racing, right? Like stuff happens, that stuff's not, we saw it at Anaheim 1 with Vince.
Yeah.
You know? And that altercation that had happened, you know? He had the jump and he started cutting over. It was a right-hand first turn, which didn't help. Mm-hmm. But yeah, it's crazy to see the kind of like the stance people take, you know? Sometimes it's a bit hardcore.
Are you glad you didn't have all that baloney when you were racing?
I mean, Instagram was still kind of around. Yeah. 06, you know, I think 05, it kind of came out, 06-ish, you know, is when it really got, but now it's a business platform, essentially.
Yeah.
That's what's really changed, you know, from when I was, you know, lights and early 450, it was just a place to like post, you know, your content and what you were doing, you know?
Yeah.
Now it's more of a whole business platform, you know, like that's kind of what keeps me, going now, you know, my followers, my things like that, like Yamaha wants to be involved, you know, all of my partners, you know, Fast House and things like that. It's, you know, they see the value in that, and it is a lot of fun.
Yeah. Do you feel like, okay, so remember when you first retired, I think, I forgot what deal it was. It might've been an ambassadorship deal or something, but you were like saying, dude, what the heck? Why can't I get this? Like, I never burned anyone during my career and everything, but like now everyone loves RV. Everyone wants RV. Like, it's kind of funny the way you gained popularity since you retired.
Yeah. I think that I've said that before, you know, like, I've always had my fans and had quite a few of them. Mm-hmm. But I think I've also gained a bunch of fans, after retirement, especially by, you know, for instance, doing those two-stroke races that were at the Nationals.
Yeah.
The 125 stuff, you know, like that, I think a lot of people got to interact with me and also realize that, like, when they came up, like, who I was when I raced isn't who I am as a person.
Yeah.
You know, like, that's my workstation. That's, you go there to work. Mm-hmm. You don't go there to just hang out and have a good time. You know, so, but doing the 125 and kind of showing back up after 5 or 6 or 7 years or whatever it was and going there just to have fun, like that's, I think, where that I kind of generated a lot of, like, either solidified my fans or, and also gained more because they're like, oh, I thought he was a dick before, you know, like loved his racing, but man, he was an ass.
Yeah.
Now they get to see more of that. Obviously they get to see more of that on Title 24. Every podcast that I either, you know, now I'm you know, a host of this podcast, but before I'd go on Pulp MX, I'd go, you know, your podcast, the Swap podcast, all these different ones. And they get to see a different side of,
yeah,
of me essentially. So, I think that's helped a lot.
Yeah. Right on, dude. Well, I know you want to get out there and do another 20.
Yeah, right.
So, thanks for the time.
Sunbathing.
And we'll see you on 420, bro.
All right.
Still smoking.